I also want to ask you about the Patriot Act. We've been talking about that. What is your take on the Patriot Act and this new law that would possibly replace it, the Freedom Act?
Good. I voted against the original Patriot Act, and I voted against its reauthorization. Let's be clear. Terrorism is a very serious problem, and there are people out there who want to do us harm. I happen to believe that, in fact, we can protect the American people without undermining our constitutional rights or our rights of privacy. I strongly object to the fact that every telephone call you make is being put on file by the NSA. There is reason to believe that the government gets into the websites that we visit, the emails that we send. So my view is, yes, we have got to be vigorous in protecting the American people from the real threat of terrorism, but we can do it in a way that does not invade privacy. We can't go around telling people we're a free country when either the government or the corporate world knows every damn thing about you. That's not really freedom.
Right.
So that's what I'm trying to do here.
So will you, for the freedom, this sort of backup bill, the substitution bill, the Freedom Act, will you vote for that?
No, I voted to allow it to proceed for debate. I will vote against it. It is better than the USA Patriot Act, but it doesn't go far enough, in my mind, in protecting our civil liberties.
I think we need better names for these things than the Patriot Act and the Freedom Act, because they're very hard. I think it should be like Friends episodes where they call it like the one about the phones. It's just like that for me would just be easier to follow. Now, something you wrote in 1972 that you've described as a piece of satire that was poorly written. I also would like to say that I have a lot of things that I wrote poorly in college. it was sort of about male fantasy and a female submission, and you said that it was like a bad 50 Shades of Grey. Now, my question to you is, considering the success of the 50 Shades of Grey books, do you regret that you did not follow that path more and not do this politics thing? You could be rolling in cash right now.
No, it was bad fiction. Okay. I learned my lesson.
Okay, great.
I think I could make a good president, but I write fiction pretty poorly.
Okay, now, there is something else that I would like to address that I think... But I would really like to stress that if this president thing doesn't work out, I also do not think your fallback plan should be as a folk singer. Now, this says to me more about Burlington, Vermont than anything. This is while you were mayor of Burlington, Vermont,
yes,
right?
Yes.
1987, is this when this? You released a folk album.
Well, it's one way of looking at it.
Okay.
There was a great band, and they said, hey, Bernie, you know, why don't you join us? Big mistake.
Big mistake, yeah.
As you will hear if you play this.
Well, let's hear real quick, and you tell us if you think this was a big mistake. It's a good jam.
As I went walking that ribbon of highway, I saw above me that endless skyway.
I saw there you go. That's perfect.
This land was made.
So now we have learned that I do bad fiction and bad music.
Yeah.
But I do have some other attributes that are better than that.
I almost feel like you should say, vote for me or I'll put out another album. Thank you so much for being here, Senator Bernie Sanders.